Hello, and welcome to another special version, special edition of my vlog. What I buy is LED calculators, so calculators that are not LCD but LED from the 70s and maybe early 80s. And I have plenty of them. Let me give you a small sample of calculators that I bought. Normally we travel through Europe. Now is a special time. Unfortunately, we have to stay at home. Cannot go out to markets, but having bought a lot of vintage technology, I now have some time to clean them up, test them, and tag them and make sure that everything is in the top condition. For example, here are some calculators that I still need to clean. As you can see, they're in a bit awkward, a bit bad condition. Some are missing the battery lids, so I try to see how they are, try to see if they work, and if they are not working, then I use them for parts. So here are some examples of calculators, and I've alphabetized these already. So Audiosonic, Brother, a lot of Casios, Canon, Citizen, some Commodores. Let me pull some out. This is a Monarch. What was it? Princetronic. Sperry Remington has a lot of calculators. And of course, Texas Instruments. As you can see, all nice retro-looking LED calculators. So let me show you some examples that I find is particularly interesting. The early LED calculators were nothing short of small computers back in the day. So you can see the same brands in the computer business, also in the calculator business. And one of the most known computer businesses, of course, is Commodore. And so you can see here some examples of the Commodore calculators. You recognize the Commodore logo. And what also nice to notice is that you see the type here, SR36. And the SR actually stands for slide rule, which is referring to the precedence of the calculator, the slide rule that was used before the invention of the pocket calculator. So Commodore is an example of a computer business in the calculator business back in the day. Another company we know from later computers, like the TRS-80, is the Tandy Radio Shack. And they use that Radio Shack brand also to create calculators. So look at this nice, really 70s design. So lovely calculator. As you can see, during the 70s, the LED calculators all came in kind of the same form factor. Some were in a landscape model, like these Casio Minis. Most of them were like four-function calculators. There were some scientific ones coming in later in the era, but some really stood out, I think, because of the design. I want to name especially this Pico. I don't know the exact brand, but it is so small, and a purple LED, which is also kind of different, that I think it's a really nice design for a calculator. Also, like the other Casio Minis, this one is also a landscape model, and they used it to integrate a clock and alarm function, a time function, And so you could put it on your nightstand if you want to calculate something in the middle of the night. I know what the reason is exactly, but it integrated time circuitry with calculation. And also kind of interesting, I think, this is a Sharp, also a landscape model, but this, it has a counter on the side. So really nice form factor. And you can count on it. You can actually count on it. So the counter button, I guess, to add things or to count people coming into your shop. I don't know. So yeah, nice designs, I think. And the German brand Brunsviga, they created a slide rule. Everybody used the slide rule before the calculators. And they integrated this. So this is not very new. You've seen a lot of slide rules that have an LCD calculator in, but having an LED calculator integrated is not something you see very often. Then another thing happened. The companies thought, okay, these are selling well. It was very popular. Everybody wanted to have the latest and greatest calculator in the 70s. Except it was mostly the men buying them. So what did they do? They created something especially for the ladies. In a fake leather red pouch with a gold keychain on it. They created this lady calculator. It is created by Triumph. So yeah, just to fit in the purse of a lady. Not sure if that really worked, but it is a very specific design, and I wanted to show you that. Normal calculators are using what they call algebraic mathematician. So adding 4 + 5, 4 + 5 =. The big difference is, what people know, is the calculators were created by Hewlett-Packard mostly using RPN, or reverse Polish notation. In reverse Polish notation, it is totally different, and some people love it. You either love it or you hate it. I personally love it.
I hate it.
I have a very big collection of Hewlett-Packard calculators, and I decided I will create a different video with those. But let me show you an RPN calculator that was not created by Hewlett-Packard, but was created by National Semiconductor. National Semiconductor was the company in America that created the chips, so the integrated circuits to create calculators. It was the most important part of the calculator, and they said, let's go in the calculator business ourselves. National Semiconductor created a brand name called Novus, and they created calculators, including this RPN calculator. So as you can see, this button is called Enter. So the same as Hewlett-Packard calculators, adding 4 + 5, you do 4, Enter 5 +. But they didn't bank on creating RPN calculators only. They also created normal algebraic calculators. So here is a Novus calculator that is normal, normal, it's algebraic. So here you do 4 + 5 = in. So here you can see an RPN and an algebraic Novus calculator side by side. It was not only in the Western part of the world, in USA and in Asia, of course, where they created the calculators, but also behind the Iron Curtain, they soon picked up on the technology. And I was able to buy some former East German calculators. Let me show you. These were created by a company called VEB, but they use a brand name RFT. So this one, it has a plug, so you might think it is only used on a desktop, but no. You can turn this knob and then you can see really nicely that this is a pocket calculator on a docking station. So it neatly docks and it can be charged on that docking station. Click it back in, turn the knob, really over-engineered, really sturdy, and you can see how big it is. Another example is that design is not that great, as they soon picked up on the 70s design as well by the same company. Also, it says Concrete, but it is an RFT Concrete, so a nice 70s, really bright orange calculator, also East German. Instead of just calculating stuff, having four function or even scientific calculators, they soon also integrated specialty things. And especially for the Scientific company, which is a tools company, they created this calculator that has special functions. I learned it is for metal cutting calculations, so very specialty, and that's nice. And it's called a cutting data calculator. Some functions were maybe less scientific or less serious. This calculator is called the Cosmos and it has a biorhythm calculator in it. I tried it and it is not year 2000 proof. So it has the millennium bug. That was no issue back in the 70s. Then lastly, you have to say something about Texas Instruments. Texas Instruments is one of the leading companies that created microchips for calculators, and of course one of the leading companies creating calculators. They were the first to create a pocket calculator, and they also revolutionized together with Hewlett-Packard pocket calculators, and that they created very nice programmable calculators. And I want to say something especially about the TI programmable 57. There was a TI programmable 57, I have several examples here, that was very popular because it was affordable. And there was a 58 and a 59 as well, which unfortunately I don't have readily available here. I will show you soon because I have some. The books were enormous that came with it. Very big, chunky books on programming the 57. You had specialty paper to write down how your program worked. The 58 and 59 included readers for magnetic cards, so you can actually save your software. You don't have to type them in every time your battery drains and got lost. And there was also, which is shown here, a docking station for the 5859 called the PC100 to dock your calculator. And you could even lock it with a key so that no colleagues could steal your extremely nice calculator. The TI 57, 58, 59 range of calculators. Oh, hi. Yeah, I have plenty of more calculators to test and to clean up. And I will show you in future videos some more interesting ones that I come across. So, so far, thank you very much for watching. And don't forget to subscribe and see you soon.